thanks for coming. It's 12:15 exactly, so we'll start off the session. Thanks for coming. Today we are lucky to have Shao. Shao is actually quite interesting. He joined VSense when he first came from school, and VSense actually has presented here before, right? And that is the visual search organization, and he was a technical person in there. And then recently he founded a new company called School, which is School Light. That's right, School Light. And School Light actually does EduTech, right? So he's sharing with us his experience as well as his perspective on EduTech.
Sure.
Okay, so without further ado, I want to give you a shout.
Sure, yeah. Thanks. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shao. I'm CEO of School Light. Today, I'd like to share more about how the future educational institute will be operating. So that's what I will be sharing. And first of all, may I know any of your friends are actually running an educational business, like a music school or a tuition center? Cool. So two of you, yeah. So as owners of educational centers, they are very busy. They need to work long hours, even on weekends, like 12 to 16 hours a day, because that's when the kids are from school or the adults are all from the work. And they need to work late in evenings, because not only for school-related work, but also for things like answering parents' phone calls, like invoicing payments and student inquiries, so a lot of stuff. So their operations are very, very traditional. So basically, they cannot, for small institute, they cannot afford to hire dedicated staff to do marketing or to do administrative things, because they are just out of hands. And then what they can do is to really like push themselves very hard to spend more time designing, distributing, printing the materials, flyers all across. But it's actually very, very inefficient, and also it's very, very expensive as well. And the effectiveness is not very easy to track. They lose track every day. Not only on the marketing side, on the daily operation side, that's the same thing. They still keep their operation materials in pen and paper, or like Excel, that's trapped in pieces, and all the things are not in one loop. So we think that future educational institute, they will be more smarter and more efficient in terms of operating, marketing, and also like student management. For now, like, can you make a guess how much does it cost to really recruit students like in Singapore, get them enrolled? Okay, there's an answer here. Yeah, basically it's very expensive, like 100 to 150 Singapore dollars, and to get someone enrolled using traditional offline approach. But we think that it can be much more reduced with the help of the online channels together with offline channels. So it's a very serious problem indeed. Out of more than 3,000 educational institutes in Singapore, more than 90% of them still operate that way. Yeah. And their way of operation is very costly and not scalable at all. And we think that technology should empower them to drive their operations and drive the schools to be more data-driven and more trackable and smarter and much more. So what we are doing is like we have talked to more than 20 schools, 20 and small and medium sized, especially the tutoring centers and enrichment schools. So we come up with a solution that can possibly help. And now we have already like 10 plus schools trying the system, and 6 are already paid. So what we do, we want to really make the whole operational. We actually create an integrated solution for schools, like to operators, to make use of all the operation data, to transfer this piece of information into organic data flow, and data to really drive the growth of the school. So there are three steps. One is student acquisition, from a potential student to an enrolled student. And second, when a student gets enrolled, how we can make use of the whole process that enrolled for in the, that the school, when the student has been enrolled in the whole school operations process, how we can make use of that kind of data. And third, by recording and analyze this information, can this really help with the student enrollment and student retention in to get more potential students come in the school? So basically three steps. And yeah, we actually try out the system and it proves that it actually helped them to reduce about 50 to 60% of original costs to recruit students using broadening their marketing channels, and also like by optimizing their advertisement campaign, and then make use of the data flow inside their organization. And yeah, so that's what we do. Yeah. So basically, the first step, let's say the student acquisition part. Basically, the schools, as I shared, they are very busy with their own stuff, and it's very difficult to figure out what works and what doesn't. And even though they may have some technical capabilities in doing, like understanding how the online, like say Facebook post works, but they don't know like how to really get people enrolled or get these things to be effective using all the different online marketing tools. So we want to really make it an easy to use all-in-one solution. Like firstly, to help them create a mini site which can drive traffic. Secondly, like they can set up the campaigns very easily with a few minutes to really promote the classes in their schools. Say, today I want to promote a guitar class for primary school in the afternoon. And he can simply choose our system to create a campaign and to share across multiple platforms. We have many, we have like adult learning and also preschool learning channels all across, not in Singapore, to set the message across. And then when the students actually register using their site, our system will record what the effectiveness of each channels, and then the schools will have a better understanding about, wow, how this worked with different channels. And fourth, not the least important, but it's like we optimize with advertisements. We partner with AI ads optimization engines to really optimize Facebook ads and Google ads. That's a part where even like for schools, they have been running for years, they have tried out, say, more than 1,000 of budget on the optimization themselves. They cannot achieve that because of their own expertise, and it takes a very long track and also a lot of trial errors to really get it right. But us, we help them really like fill in the gap to understanding how the online marketing and ads, online ads works, and to really like give them conversions. So on average, we are getting about 2 to 4 conversions per weekly campaign at $50, which is so much better than what they have originally. Yeah. Yes, so this part is maybe, if you have any further questions, we can further discuss. And second is the student lifecycle management. Once the student gets enrolled, then what the school has been, then the, all the students' life cycle in terms of, say, attendance and invoice. house in terms of student profiling, demographics, and financial, all kinds of information. And now in the stage of performance analysis and data tracking as well. So in the future, it can be so much more useful. Imagine that the data has been gathered for years and with a lot of schools, and we can really give a lot of smart analysis and smart suggestions, business intelligent suggestions. One of the examples can be like from our system, we actually can really predict, we analyze that the second week of May will be a very good time for like summer camp promotions. But if a school, they don't know this information, they promote too early or too late, then they lose again. This is a very simple example. Another example can be like, say, a student, an adult student has been absent for two consistent sessions for, and he hasn't been attending. But this teacher hasn't informed the owner. Then this student has the potential to really quit. So the system should really suggest the owner that, okay, he or she should really do something to promote or to really retain students. So that's a very simple example. More example can be found, like one of the example probably like when a teacher, for teacher assessment, based on the student grades, attendance, and also these feedbacks, how the students, the teacher is performing can really be assessed, and then can help improve the teaching quality as well as the satisfaction of the students and parents. So all this information can be very useful for the owners. And we think that the future school operators, the future school owners, will really need to depend on such kind of smart system to empower their operation in the future. If they don't do it now, maybe in the future they will start to see that, okay, they are not doing that well compared to what they can potentially become. So we have some competitive analysis regarding how we are different from the market solutions. One is like all the current solutions are not very smart. They are divided into trunks. It's very fragmented. And in terms of ERP, student involvement, CRM, learning materials, and for ours, we make it a whole loop. So that's our competitive advantage. Okay, there's a lot of opportunity in the Southeast Asia, especially. In Singapore, the market size is not that big in terms of student school management. But in terms of whole Southeast Asia, it's actually quite noticeable. And it's not only about academics. There are so many other things like music, sports, like public speaking, even, all kind of things, arts. Can we all be using this system? And it is very interesting that Southeast Asia is a whole blue ocean here, that no one is competing with us. So we have a good potential to go. And now, as I shared, we have 15 schools already testing in Singapore and 6 in Pay. And we are charging like a basic monthly fee plus like surcharge of the upselling part. It's more like a SaaS model. So once they are stuck in the system, they don't have so much intention to quit because all the student information management are in the system. And it's really like a rigid demand that we are not really creating some demand that doesn't exist. It's a rigid demand here. And it's highly frequently used. Every day, the owners need to take a look at how the school is performing. And on top of the management part, as I shared, the upselling part is getting a lot of potential revenues for us. end size, which we charge relatively low, but for the medium size and larger size, it's going to be so much more budget out there. So basically, for the timeline here, we hope that we want to really enter into the Malaysian market by end of this year. This by from now on, we are still polishing the whole product and really testing out more in the Singapore market. And I do find Malaysia, Indonesia, Vietnam, and some even Philippines can be very good markets for our solution. Basically, me, I'm the CEO of Schoolight. I've been working more than 3 years for EduTech specific products. So I'm very product oriented guy. So we have been working on a MOOC platform, which has been used by more than 1 million users back in China. But we also have solutions in Indonesia and in other places, which has been used for more than 10,000 users. So for us, in terms of capability, system scalability, our team is so good at that. And say Zoe and Rick, we have been working together for years. We have been working with very big scale projects together since our school time when as students. Anyways, and we have the data scientist advisor from the NUS. He's actually one of the top data scientists in the NUS. And the UX lead, he's very, I would say he will be probably the top three SaaS or like B2B solution architects and design, UX designer in Singapore. Also our business and financial advisor. She has helped a lot in terms of how to really position ourselves in terms of the business aspects and in terms of getting more knowledge on our business and also like how we can move forward. Yeah. Okay, so basically we are also running the seed round from now on till probably August to September. So we'll close the seed round this year. Then we hope to really move forward to try out markets all across Southeast Asia. Yes, thanks. So we hope that future educational institutions will really benefit from our system to be more data-driven and smarter. Yeah. We teach and you teach and we do the rest. That's our
motto.
Thanks.
Any question for Sean?
Does this work for, say, coaching businesses or kinds of recruitments? Recruiting smaller number of clients or whatever.
Yes. Basically, like for now, we are starting with SMEs, like which has 30 to 50 students. So that's, I think, aligned with the category we're referring to. And for the training and coaching business, yeah, that's a very good aspect as well. That's adult learning. We are, the two categories that works the best for us is like preschool and adult learning. So coaching is actually one of the categories there. But the coaching, in terms of coaching, there will be some specific requirements, say some payment related thing. Can this system support, or they will need some specific customizations on some portions of the whole system. But yes, it is workable for coaching businesses.
There is a huge market out there that there are a lot of individuals that is actually wanting to teach. Right.
Yes.
So what they do is that they adjunct in some universities,
yes,
but they also actually, teach their own classes. Right.
Yes.
So the question is that today,
yes,
the number of students is in my head.
Yes.
If I'm the teacher, slides.
Yes, yes.
Right? You can keep track of all the way from, you know, the functions and features.
Yes.
Further down, further down, further down. The CRM. So it doesn't have student environment at the moment, but they do teach a class, right?
Yes.
Maybe 10 people, maybe 5 people, right?
Yes.
And then CRM is how do they keep track of the people to keep marketing? Is there any cross-sell, upsell?
Yes.
Right? And then ERP help them collect money and manage them, you know?
Sure.
Right? And certainly they would not afford a learning system.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
So how can, you know,
so
you bundle this for them?
Basically, Mr. Chai is thinking about another bigger market for individuals.
Yes.
So it's not only for the business owners.
Right.
Individual teachers or the coaches also
right.
would like to use this. We do think this is very possible and a very big market. But I think the price needs to be lowered up.
So if I can find you some people, would you want to work with them and see how we could actually build this system for them?
Yes, we can.
Piano teacher, music teacher.
Sure.
Right.
We can try out that, and we can see, like, how the price model can be workable for these people.
Right.
Yeah, I think that's a bigger, very big market out there.
Right. So, for example, your ERP would be that, once a very simple invoicing system that can get emailed out. If I'm a piano teacher, every month I send out. Automatic, I don't even have to worry.
Yes.
But today, of course, I don't send out, there's no cost to me.
Yes.
I just go there and put my hand out and then the money will come.
Yes. Actually, the invoice system is one of the top features that the current schools really like. I think that will be really beneficial for the business and for the individuals. Cool.
The targeting aspect of your
so we simplify the process. Our system, the owners, they only need to check the category, the top category, say they want to target for primary school, tuition, on language, Chinese language, and then they just click, and then we optimize in the back end. Because we have the back end engine to optimize all the parameters. They only need to choose the very dummy parameters. That's it. To make it dummy set like proven.
Okay. So the let's say for the coaching business then you have to code some more and tweak some more, right?
Yes. We need to tweak a bit and then plus another category and then tweak based on the category itself. So that's how it works.
So I guess the other business grows, that business itself can learn more about various markets and be a way to acquire customers. But that itself can be an interesting business actually.
Yes.
Many people want to acquire customers.
Sure. That will be really. And in actually, we are also making the whole creative creation parts to be more smarter. So, like, which are the banners that are attracting the most target users? And we are getting more data parts on that. So to assist our current business owners to create better campaigns. So that's something that in the future we can also help these to really like make the whole process even like more efficient and more like data proven as well.
So in your model, you're sort of dangling the carrot of customer acquisition and getting it cheaper.
Yes.
But then the hook to keep them in there, you are supplying the rest of the system to keep it within your
When more students are getting from the system and all the information are locked in the system, we will give a better understanding of what to target for and who to target for as well.
Yes. What drives you to start this organization?
Actually, I have this kind of methodology or mentality that you need to involve in startup before you do your own. So So I actually, before I do this, I've been really trying to arrow a lot of startups. And back in Sweden in 2012, I started with like a language matching platform.
You're from Sweden?
No, I'm from China, but
okay.
I studied in the US.
Oh,
and I exchanged in Sweden, yeah. So, and that time, I started doing this kind of things. And then in Singapore, I tried out different like tutor matching platform, and it doesn't work out. And then we try out lifestyle learning to do matching. And then at the same time, we think that, okay, the B2B sector is the part that the educational institute are really paying. And also, this is the future way to go. And then we start to really like dive deep into this. And then gradually we come up with the solution. And for education, it's really like my top passion all across a few years, because I do think that if the education sector can really benefit more students and benefit more people, and that's going to really impact more to the society and in a bigger world to the world, right? So that's what
sounds to me that you really want. You already had an idea of being an entrepreneur quite early on, right?
Yeah,
when was that? Is it in school or?
Yeah, it's
like what drives you, right? You
yes.
have that thinking that you want to be an entrepreneur.
Initially, I want to be an academic guy, but
that's quite far away.
Yeah, it was quite far away. But after I entered into a class which is taught by one of the teachers in the US. You may have heard about his name is Ben Bell.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
So he's very entrepreneurial. So he encouraged the student to really do the fullest of what they actually can do. So I was really inspired by him, indeed. Initially, I thought academic is something that I should be pursuing. But after I attending one of his class, I find that, okay, yeah, with the knowledges and skills that we have in our hand, we can do much more with the entrepreneurial approach instead of academic approach. Yeah. And you know, like the top A plus student all went for the academics, but if I'm A minus or B plus, why should I bother to go for the academic? And there's so big words, such a big word out there for me. Yeah. And it proves to be like that, but indeed every single track is not so easy. You need to learn along the way. So I think like learning in this past really works pretty good for me and my team. And we have been working together for long years, and we find that this is something that we are passionate about. Yeah.
Well, you're in a quite competitive space, right? I mean, you know, there are a lot of software out there that you can do, like you say, across all, right, different things, right? I mean, like NUS will not buy a software because you know, they have huge software that they use to actually run their own entire, you know,
yes.
10,000 students or whatever. You know.
Yeah.
So your market is actually one down, right?
So, yeah, it depends on how you look at things.
Okay.
Basically, if you are looking into a generic solution, say
yes.
SAP or Microsoft or Salesforce, these kind of big players, yes, they can be a big competitor for us, but for us as a small startup, we choose a vertical domain that they cannot do so good like than us. Same as business, they start as a shopping business. They don't really do whole thing. Otherwise, how can they compete with Google? Yeah. So the same thing for us. We really want to be the number one or number two. I would say definitely number one in Southeast Asia for this, the whole solution for the student life cycle management. And that's, I don't think that's a very difficult thing to do. In terms of technology capability, it's not a doubt for us. In terms of business and sales, I think we have a long way to go. Yes, we need to get more, better people to get involved. In terms of product, we are learning along the way, and we might not be the best product guy, but we are getting better and better. And think if we really can do so well in the educational space, and that's a very good proof to our company, our capability and our vision, and I think that's fulfilled enough. I don't want to be like another Salesforce. I think it doesn't make sense to become another Salesforce. But if we can do the best in this subdomain, yes, it's possible.
Tell me more about the student enrollment process that you guys use. What do you all do to, you know, how do you onboard people? How do you get them, you know, take them from interested to the next level? Or like?
Yeah. Basically, I shared a few slides, but this is not the complete one. Basically, we need to really one big thing is really to outreach as many channels of potential audience as possible. So that's the part that we are working on. And when the students are get registered in our landing page, then we have another lead tracking process to help them to really get interested and really come and sign up. So that's handled by the whole marketing plus the lead tracking. Lead tracking, we initially turned it as the CRM, but it's only part of the CRM. Yeah. So all the things can be actually, now it's still like based on some of the, like our experiences, like how will work best, what will work best. But eventually this process will also be smarter as well, like by giving templates, by giving like the exact time and date to follow up. And to really like calm down and see like what really what should we do in the next action. Yeah. So all these things can be done much smarter in the future based on the information that we have.
But beta currently is leaning heavily towards for now it's kids. For now it's a kids data.
Kids data.
Well, the data that's pertaining to is it the six schools that you have or your clients right now, are they more?
They are like more adult language learning.
And adult language learning.
Okay.
Yeah, and also like child preschool, like kind of activities.
Okay.
And also language schools. Yeah, I think language schools are very good, and music school we are approaching now. And we find fitness clubs are also somewhat relevant. But for now, I think not only for the preschool kids, but also for adults also. But the one tricky part is the secondary school and primary school and JC part. That part relying on online marketing doesn't work that well. Yeah.
So basically, for the kids, you're targeting the parents.
Yes, yes.
And then the adult, you're targeting the adult learner.
Yes, yes.
So therefore, even if you talk about secondary school or JC or whatever, the target generally is still the parents,
yes.
Not the kids, right?
Yes.
The kids, not many of them would want to go to tuition. No?
Yes, yes. Still the parents, but the channels that we use right now doesn't prove to be that high in terms of conversion.
So you have some data?
Yeah, we have some data.
Okay.
Which means like for the cost for primary school, secondary school will be much higher than preschool. Yeah. So that's I think it's understandable in a way. But for these schools, they are very interested in our platform as well because we have the mini sites, which can actually give them better rankings in terms of SEO. That's what they are valuing because they are thinking, okay, I want more branding. Brand awareness. I don't see that the conversion can be so good at this moment, but I really value that you can bring my brand awareness to a much exposed level. So yeah, but it's a bit different like to targeting on the preschool sector, the secondary sector, and also the adult sector. But I find
adventurist actually play a good, very important part in forming actually, you know, his entrepreneurial spirit. So we rescued one person from being academic.
but he's still a long way to go. He can still go back and teach later.
Of course. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We all cool, huh? Yeah. All right, the pizza is here, so please serve yourself. Thank you very much, Algin.
Thank you.